Hello everyone and welcome back to The Perfect French with Dylan. Today we are on lesson 54 of the pronunciation course. This is the French reading practice number 2. For the book it's on page 94 and 95. The recordings are number 102 for the slow version and 103 for the normal version. Don't forget to spend a lot of time on the listening practice. This is very important. If you can't hear sound, you can't pronounce it. So quick reminder how we do the French reading practice. We are going to see the silent letters, les lettres muettes. Then we see the links, les liaisons. And finally, les sons, the sounds. And today's topic is ma journée idéale. This lesson is already going to be very long, so the translation is going to be in the description box. Alright, so let's read the little text first. Ma journée idéale est une journée sans responsabilité ni horaire. Me lever à l'heure que je veux, manger quand j'en ai envie et me coucher quand je suis fatiguée. Si le temps le permet, j'irai faire une randonnée en montagne. Admirer le coucher de soleil, partager un bon repas avec ma famille et terminer la soirée autour d'un feu de bois. Et vous, quelle serait votre journée idéale? Alright, so let's jump into the silent letters, the letters that we do not pronounce. So, ma journée. Ma, we pronounce everything. You know that the two-letter words, usually we pronounce everything. Journée. Journée ends with E-E. We are not going to pronounce the E at the end. Journée idéale. Idéal. We don't need the E at the end. We don't say idéal. We don't say that. Idéal. Est une journée. Et make a very specific sound that we're going to see later. Une. Une. I pronounce the U, I pronounce the N. I don't pronounce the E. Une. Journée. Journée ou just sona. Sans responsabilité. So, sans, we don't pronounce the final S, I don't say sens, don't say that. Responsabilité, responsabilité. We also don't pronounce the S at the end. Ni horaire, horaire. So the H is always silent in French, this is no exception. And the E at the end is also silent. Me lever. Me lever, we pronounce everything here, à l'heure, à l'heure. Like I said, the H is always silent in French. À l'heure, same thing for the final E, à l'heure que, que. Here we don't pronounce the U after the Q. Que, que. Je veux, je veux. So, veux, I don't say veux. I say veux, so the X is silent. Manger quand j'en ai envie. Manger, we pronounce everything, or at least everything is there to make a specific sound. Manger quand. Quand. The U is silent and the D is silent as well. U and D. So quand. Quand. J'en ai envie. J'en ai envie. So, j'en ai, good, envie. Envie, the last E is not pronounced. Et me coucher, we pronounce everything. Quand, we just saw this one, U and D, silent. Je suis fatiguée. Je, we pronounce everything. Suis, suis. This one, the S is silent. Suis. Fatigué, fatigué. The U after the G is silent is there to make sure that we pronounce the G as a hard G. Fatigué. Then we have the E-E at the end. The E-E is very specific for woman or person who identify as a woman. If it's only a E, it's going to be for a man or a person who identifies as a man. So since I'm reading the text, technically I would have to make E-E, but we don't pronounce the E. Let's move on. Si le temps le permet. Si le, we pronounce everything. Temps, temps. Then we have the P and we have the S that are silent. Le permet. Permet. The T is silent. I don't say permettre. C'est permet. J'irai faire une randonnée. J'irai. J'irai. Here the S at the end is silent. J'irai. Faire. Faire. So the last letter that I pronounce is the R. Faire une. Une. The E is silent. We've seen that. Randonnée. Randonnée. Once again. Et E at the end, we only pronounce the E. En montagne. Montagne. So the E at the end, I don't say montagneux. Nye. I say montagne. Admirer le coucher de soleil. Admirer, we good. Le coucher, we good. De soleil. We don't have any silent letter in that line. It's actually pretty surprising for French. Partager, partager, we pronounce everything. Un bon, un bon. Repas, repas. De S at the end is silent. Repas. Avec ma famille. Avec ma famille. So, avec, we pronounce everything. Ma, same thing. Famille. Famille. So, here we don't pronounce the E at the end. Famille. Et terminer la soirée. Et terminer. Those two words, we pronounce everything. La, we pronounce everything. Soirée, soirée. Once again, et E at the end, we don't pronounce the E. I don't know if you will believe me, but I actually did not plan to have that many words with et E at the end, I swear. Autour d'un feu de bois. So, autour, the last letter that I pronounce is the R. D'un, d'un, feu, feu, de, bois, bois. Here the S is silent. Et vous. Et vous. 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 The S is silent. Quelle serait. Quelle. Quelle. Here we have two silent letters. We have the U. So the U after Q is always silent. And then we have the E at the end. Quelle. Serait. Serait. We don't need the T. Serait. Votre. Votre, tr, tr, the last one that I pronounce is the R. Votre, journée, we've seen this one. Idéal, we've seen it as well. Now if you look at the links, les liaisons. We have only two in this text. I don't know if you heard it yet. But let's see. The first sentence. Ma journée idéale est une journée, est une journée. So here we have a T. The T from est is going to be transferred to une. Est une. Est une. Journée sans responsabilité ni horaire. Me lever à l'heure que je veux. Manger quand j'en ai envie. Manger quand j'en ai envie. J'en ai, né. So here the N from en is going to be transferred to et. J'en ai envie. And that's it for this one. That's the only two links that we have in this lesson. Now the sounds. So we are going to see this text in two different parts just because it's long and I need to put little notes between the lines. So let's see. Ma journée. Ma. Ma. There's nothing really complicated about the pronunciation of ma. Journée. Journée. Everything is pronounced as is, just O-U make the sound OU. OU. Journée. Journée. Idéal. 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 Et. Et. Make the sound et. Et. Thune. Journée. Same thing. O-U make the sound OU. Sans. Sans. This one is interesting because A-N make the sound EN, exactly like E-N. sans responsabilité. This one is complicated to pronounce, I think, but it's actually quite easy. So yeah, responsabilité. The first E is pronounced as a E. Why? Because it's followed by two consonants. I feel like I've been repeating that the whole course. Responsabilité. Then we have O-N, make the sound on, on. And if we look at the S, the two S are pronounced as S, just the regular pronunciation, because they have before or after a consonant. So in this case, we pronounce them as a S, not as a Z. Next one, ni, ni, easy. Horaire, horaire. This word is a bit more complicated. So the O here is going to be a hard O, a close O, because there's the R after that come and close the sound. Rare, rare. So the A-I make the sound E. Horaire. Me lever. Me, me, pronounce the E as a E. Lever. Here we have two different types of E. The first one is a regular E, and then the second one, lever. V is a E. ER make the sound E at the end. À l'heure. A, A. It's a regular pronunciation for A. The accent here is just to differentiate with the A, which is the verb avoir, to have. À l'heure. L'heure. So here the EU is also a closed sound because the R comes after and close it. L'heure. Que. Que, the E is pronounced as a E. Je, same thing. Veux. So this one is an open sound. Because we don't have anything after that comes and closes the sound, because the X is not pronounced. So we have heure, and then we have veux. Heure, veux. Do you hear the difference? So this one is an open sound. Now we have manger. Manger, manger. And the only letter that actually stays the same is M. So, A-N is pronounced as en, en, E-N. Same spelling as E-N. The G is turning into a soft G because it's followed by a E. J, j, mange. And then we have E-R that sounds like a E. Manger. Quand, quand. So here, the only thing that we pronounce is Q. And then we're going to pronounce A-N as en. Quand? Jean. Jean. So E-N, make the sound en. Né. 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 So here, A-I make the sound E. So the pronunciation here, né, is the exact same pronunciation as if you will talk about your nose in French. Né. Envie. So here, envie. E-N, make the sound en. Envie. And the E is a rolling E. Et me coucher. E-T make the sound et. Me, the E is pronounced as a E. Coucher. Coucher. We have two different sounds here. So we have the O-U that make the sound OU. The C is a hard C. Coucher. Che. So we have E-R at the end that make the sound et. Quand, we saw quand. A-N make the sound en. Je suis. Je. Je. The E is pronounced as a E. Suis. 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 This one, the UI is pronounced as a W et WI. Suis. Fatigué. Fatigué. Here there is nothing really specific. It's just the G stay a hard G because we have the U after. The U is there to make sure that we pronounce the G as a hard G. If there was no U, that would be fatigué, fatigué, and not fatigué. Make sense? Second part. Si le temps. Si, easy. Le, we pronounce the E. Temps, temps. E-M make the sound en is exactly as E-N, A-N, etc. Here it's spelled as E-M just because it's followed by a P. It's just a spelling here. It's just for the spelling. Temps, le, E. Permet, permet. So here the E is pronounced as a E because it's followed by two consonants. And then we have ET at the end that makes also the sound E. Permet. J'irai. J'irai. Here the AI at the end makes the sound E because it's followed by a S. If there was no S at the end, it would make the sound E. Okay? J'irai. So we do have a silent letter, but the silent letter is there for a very good reason. If there is no silent S, the pronunciation will be totally different. J'irai faire, faire. AI is also pronounced as a E because it's in the middle of the word. Une, randonnée, randonnée. AN make the sound en, the O is a short O, is a close O, rando, do, ne. So here we could think that ON is going to be pronounced as on. It's not the case because we have two N. So the two N are pronounced just like regularly. We pronounce every single letter. Randonnée. En montagne. En montagne. So EN is pronounced as en montagne, montagne. So you see here, ON makes the sound on because there's a consonant after that comes and closes it. Montagne. Here, don't forget also that the GN is pronounced a bit like a ni, ni. It's a bit of an I at the end. Montagne. Okay? Admirer. Admirer. ER is pronounced as a E. Le coucher de soleil. Le, E, coucher. We've seen this one where we're talking about me coucher. So, OU make the sound OU, ER make the sound E. De, de, soleil, soleil. So, the S at the beginning is pronounced as a S because it's the first letter of the word, so it's always going to be pronounced as a S. The O is a short O, close O, and then the L is pronounced regularly. N, E, I, L make the sound E, I. E, I. Soleil, E, I. Okay, so that's the E plus the rolling E. Let's keep going. Partager. Partager. So the G here turns into a soft G because it's followed by ER and it's going to make the sound E. Partager. Un. UN make the sound un. Bon. Bon. So here there's only the B that we pronounce regularly. Then we have the ON make the sound on. Repas. Repas. Here we have the E that stays a E, and then the PA just pronounced regularly. Repas. Avec. Avec. We've seen this one yesterday, so avec, the E is pronounced as a E. I think we've seen this one yesterday. Not too sure actually. Avec. Ma famille. Ma famille. So ma, there's nothing different about the pronunciation. Then we have famille. Famille. Here we have the I followed by the rolling I. Famille. Okay? Et terminé. Et. E-T make the sound et. Terminé. Terminé. Technically, you should be able to know which sound it is now. So the E is going to be pronounced as a E because it's followed by two consonants. Then we have ER at the end that make the sound et. Terminé. La soirée. La, we good. Soirée, soirée. So OI is pronounced as a W and a E. W-A. Soi, soi. Soi, soirée. Autour, autour. So AU is very interesting because it makes the sound of a soft O, an open O. O, O, tour, tour. So, autour, O-U make the sound O. D'un, d'un. So, D'apostrophe U-N, U-N make the sound un. Feu, feu. E-U make the sound E, an open E, not a close E. Feu. De, de. Bois, bois. Can you guess the pronunciation of this one? Bois. So, it's B-W-A, bois. Bois. And the last sentence, et vous. Et vous. So, ET make the sound E. Vous, OU make the sound OU. Quel, quel. So, the U is not pronounced, so the E is going to be pronounced as a E because it's before two consonants, which are the double L. Quel. Serait, serait. The first one is a E. Serait, A-I at the end make the sound E because it's followed by a T. Votre, votre. So here the O is a close O. Votre. Journée. Journée. We sing that one. And then we have the last word. Idéal. Idéal. So that's it. You went through another French reading practice. I hope you understood everything. I hope everything made sense. If you have a question, please let me know in the comment section. I would be more than happy to help you. And I will see you tomorrow for the last lesson of the course, French reading practice number 3. À demain.